I went to Cleveland High School in the city of St. Louis. Encouragement to attend college was pretty limited in those days, but I had parents that insisted that my sister and I go to college.
Growing up, Bill was, I think, just a great kid. He was always energetic and full of fun. We were blessed to have not a lot of money, but a tremendous set of opportunities to experience all kinds of things. We were 2 years apart. He always introduces me, of course, as his much older sister.
Bill Seidhoff earned 2 degrees from Washington University, his bachelor's degree from University College in Arts and Sciences, and a master's degree from the Brown School of Social Work.
I think many people have been in the same circumstance, and particularly those at University College, where they're trying to do both, go to school and at the same time hold a full-time job, which I did, and it was very challenging, but I think I was a better and stronger person for the experience that I had. I began my career as a caseworker. My job was to serve clients in the Pruitt-Igoe housing complex. I learned an awful lot very quickly, and within 5 years I became the director of the Division of Family Services in the city. I took a position when Mayor Francis Slay, serving as the director of the Department of Human Services for the city.
He's done a remarkable job of dealing with very tough social issues, and I think he's really understood how to help individual people, but also to be an agent for change.
Mr. Seidhoff has devoted both his personal and professional life to serving others. In addition to supporting many of the region's premier cultural organizations, he has served in leadership roles for institutions that serve people with disabilities, children and youth in crisis, seniors, veterans, and St. Louisans experiencing hunger and homelessness.
In 2001, we had about 2,000 homeless people in the city, and when I left in 2014, we had about 1,000.
He is a person who immediately lights up a room. He has a remarkable resilience to see the good, the positive, in what he does. I'm very proud of Bill because I think he stuck with what he believed in.
I keep having people tell me, I said, you need to learn how to say no. I said, well, St. Louis Crisis Nursery, for example, they are providing incredible services to as many as 7,000 kids a year. So it's very hard for me to say, no, I really don't have the time to help you. I'll find the time.
Many institutions have honored Mr. Seidhoff's achievements and service, including Washington University's Brown School of Social Work and Gebhardt Institute for Civic and Community Engagement.
This particular award that recognizes my contributions, and it's coming from my alma mater, and that gives you special significance. When it's your own university that you attended, I think those things are very special and very much appreciated. One person I do want to thank is Mary Ellen Cotsworth, who I've now been with for about 13 years, who I met at Washington U over 40 years ago. I believe that the experience that I had here at Washington University really contributed a great deal to my ability to be able to address some very serious needs in our city and region.
I think Washington University totally changed his life. We were both first in the family. I was first, he was second, so he doesn't get full credit, but we were both first generation college students. I think Washington University gave him the pathway to a very successful future.
I think it's important that everybody give back in some way. So that's really what drives the things that I do, whether it be in volunteering, contributing to the school directly, scholarship that I established here at Washington U. I think if everybody would engage in that kind of behavior, we'd see a much better world.